Hello friends, today I am starting the topic of meaning of economic development. Okay, first you remember one thing. We have earlier understood about economic progress or economic growth, right? In that we have already understood that only increase in total production is considered. But when we are discussing about economic development, here it is the concept directly connected with developing nations. You have to keep in your mind that which kind of countries of Asia, countries of Africa, and countries of Latin America, as well as I could say some countries of Europe too, are considered as developing nations. So generally, economic development is a process, a continuous process to achieve well-being, to reach up to best, right? It is called economic development. So economic development is a wider aspect. On one side, it includes total production. Second side, it includes upliftment of the standard of life of people. And third side, it includes every change in lifestyle of the people by earning better. So here I say economic development includes three aspects. First, economic growth, upliftment. Second, economic welfare, change in lifestyle. And third, economic progress, increase in total production, right? So remember this concept as economic development. So sometime this question may come, which aspects are included in economic development? Economic growth, economic progress, and economic welfare. Remember this. Okay, now here I want to discuss anything more. That we have earlier studied that the income increase. Also, we have understood that income includes two kind of incomes. First, national income. Second, per capita income. Per capita means per person income. So economic development is also associated with quantitative change as well as qualitative change. First, increase in income, and second, change in lifestyle of human beings. Everything is included here. So, in easy manner, you could say that economic development is almostly different than economic growth. So, it is also including economic growth. It is not excluding, but including, right? So, it is a multidimensional process. Remember, economic development is multidimensional process. Okay. Second thing, if the process of development continues, what other things will change? The other things will change is social structure will be changed. Okay. See, social structure directly is connected with society, It is a social concept. But here in economics, when I am talking about social structure, means upper, lower, poor, and rich. In this way, we are discussing. So, all the kind of the changes in the society are coming in economic way, is I am saying to that. Okay. Now remember one thing. Progress happening, but not only to individual, but also includes progress or the changes in the better way coming in the whole society. So, change comes in structure of national income too. Primary sector's income will increase, industrial sector's income will increase, service sector's income in all the way. In all the way, total income increase. But the ratio of increase in income of the agriculture will be less. So sometime it may happen that the agricultural sector's income will reduce because as the development starts, the importance of the agricultural sector reduce and importance of the secondary and the service sector increase. So it is possible that who are not getting employment in agriculture and forcibly they are bound to stay in the agriculture, they will get opportunity of employment in other sectors too. So, in present days, as the modern technology comes, mainly every sector of economy try to save the money and time means ultimately I could say every sector of economy try to reduce cost of production and also increase total productivity. So for that point of view, you can say so many things that new methods are coming, new instruments are coming, and ultimately the productivity increase, but cost of production decrease. So the production cost in the market, which could be say MRP, maximum retail price, will be less due to the change in the production methods. And here the demand will increase, the new production comes, and so many new opportunities are coming. Due to that, poverty will reduce too, due to the unemployment also reduce. So here it is a larger aspect which I have said about economic development. It is a wider concept. It is not a smaller concept. So as I discussed, I would like to underline some point. First, developing nations are related to the economic development. Second, term of economic development includes three aspects like economic growth, second, economic welfare, and third, economic progress. Third point, economic development includes two kind of the income, national income and per capita income, with qualitative and quantitative both kind of positive changes. Fourth, economic development is a multidimensional process. Fifth, economic development is changing social structure of every economy. So due to that, all sectors of economy are also changing as service sector is increasing, इंडस्ट्रियल सेक्टर इज इंक्रीजिंग एंड एग्रीकल्चर सेक्टर इज डिक्रीजिंग. नेक्स्ट, न्यू मॉडर्न टेक्नोलॉजी इज कमिंग इन द फील्ड सो द प्रोडक्शन कॉस्ट डिक्रीज, टाइम एंड द रिसोर्स विल सेव्ड एंड ड्यू टू दैट द प्रोडक्शन इंक्रीज बट कॉस्ट रिड्यूस. सो ऑल्सो विद दैट द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन मेथड विल ऑल्सो चेंज, द प्रोडक्शन मेथड विल ऑल्सो चेंज, न्यू पीपल आर ऑल्सो गेटिंग एम्प्लॉयमेंट इन सो मैनी सेक्टर्स, सो पॉवर्टी विल रिड्यूस एंड अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट विल ऑल्सो रिड्यूस. सो दिस 7 or 8 पॉइंट्स यू कुड अंडरस्टैंड बाय एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ इकोनॉमिक डेवलपमेंट, राइट. नाउ आई एम डिस्कसिंग टू द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट विथ डेफिनेशंस ऑफ इकोनॉमिक डेवलपमेंट. ओके, हियर आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग 3 डेफिनेशंस. You have already heard me. 3 definitions I am explaining. First, economic development is multidimensional process because it is not changing one sector but all sectors are included in it. I repeat, it is a definition of Todero, Michael Todero. I repeat, it is definition of Michael Todero, and he said economic development is multidimensional process. Second, this is the definition of G.M. Mayer. Economic development is such a process in which no increase in population living below poverty line. See, no increase. Every point I am dividing to explain. No increase in population living below poverty line. Also, distribution of income does not increase the inequality, so the inequality will not increase. Third, continuous rise in per capita income for long period will increase. So here it is a directly affecting to the lifestyle. Very clearly I am saying 3 aspects here discussed by G.M. Mayer. First, he said the population living below poverty line will not increase. Second, he says due to the economic development process, inequality will not increase. Third, he says per capita income continuously increase, not for some time but for long period. And when I am talking about long period, it must be more than 3 years is discussed here. 3 or 5 years, you can understand that. Okay, the third expression is given by McClub. He says economic development is a process which increases factors of production and create change in technique of production. First, what he says, factors of production will increase, right? Second, he says technique of production will change due to per capita income increase and continuously rise in standard of life without looking to population remain constant increasing. So here I repeat, first McClub says factors of production increase. Second, he says technique of production will change. Third, he says per capita income continuously increase. Here I am using the word continuously. Fourth, he says standard of life continuously rise without looking to population. either stable or increasing. Means even population is increasing or remains stable, but standard of life continuously positively change. With that, our per capita income is also increasing. Here he also say that the technique of production is also changing, and also he include one thing, that the factors of production is also increasing. It means all positive aspects are included in a one concept. So it is a multidimensional and wider concept as my own explanation, right? So here I completed discussion of economic development and its definition, right? Here I concluded.